Joe's Garage.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome back to Jimbo's Garage. Well, a local geotechnical engineering firm here in town, I do a lot of work for. They asked me to design and build a lot of testing equipment and tooling, and that's exactly what we're going to be doing here today. It's going to be involving a little bit of plasma cutting, a little bit of TIG welding, and a little bit of lathe work. So let me bring in, I'm going to show you the existing plate, and I'll show you the changes we're going to be doing to the new one. Okay, so here's the existing plate that we're going to be replicating. This is about 9 3/4 inches wide and 14 inches long. This is currently made out of aluminum. We're not making the new one out of aluminum. You can see that there's some sort of a foot tread design on here. That's something else that we're not going to be doing on the new one. This has a 4-inch tall round collar that is designed for a 3/4 inch solid round pin to be driven down through here into the ground. And then that when they drive that into the ground, then they pull this away and a piece of equipment goes on here and measures the density of the soil. At one time, this had a handle going across here, and that's what's used to lift this off the ground. This seems to be the problem that they've been having, is its handles breaks a lot. And so that's one of the things we're going to change. The other one is we're going to take this collar and we're going to put another one on this side right here so that this plate will be interchangeable in either direction and you can use it on either side. Now the dimensions from here to here and from here to here are critical based on the piece of equipment that sits on top of this after this plate is removed. So we're going to put the exact same dimensions here over here, and then that is going to give us our span across here that we're going to put a piece of 3/4 inch round tube across here, and that's going to create the handle. So hopefully that's going to be a lot more functional. We're also going to be making the pin that goes along with it. It's roughly 20 inches long, 3/4 in diameter, and we're going to sharpen it to a semi point on the end, and we're going to be doing that on the lathe. So this is going to be involving some plasma cutting to get the plate cut out and some TIG welding to get these collars in place and the handle in place, and a little bit of lathe work. So let's get started in today's video. Now, I have already created this file, so I'm just gonna go to the file. I'm gonna look for the file that we're gonna be doing and select it down here. And there it is, it's showing up down here, and this is the this corner right here. So we're gonna go ahead and move the cutting head. All right, so I've got the cutting head into the position. I've actually got 4 of these to make. We're gonna cut one plate out right now just to show you how this is gonna happen. I'm gonna turn on the cutter. And we are using the HTP Microcut 875SC. I haven't had any problems with the delusional design table or the cutter since I've had it for almost 4 months now. So let's go ahead and select this part and see if we can cut something out. All right, so I've got the 1/4 inch plate on there. I've selected everything we need to do. Everything is on. The only thing left to do is go ahead and select cut. So let's go ahead and see how it works. All right, so here it is right off the plasma table, and you can see that, it's perfectly cut, and I don't know if you can see how perfectly clean the cuts actually are. I'll try to get you a good shot of that. But there it is, very little, just some dross on the outside, nothing that the grinder won't, angle grinder won't take care of. We're gonna do that. But just like that, in just about a minute's time, we got a plate cut out. All right, so there's a pretty good close up of the cut right there, and you can see how nice and perfectly clean this is. And this is not only just on the outside, but even the holes on the inside. Everything super clean, super true. I've had no issues with it, with just a very little amount of dross on the outside. But we're gonna go ahead and just trim that up just a little bit with the welder,
I'm using a Walter Mini right here. This grinder is one of my favorites. They offer up several different sizes, but this one here has got a paddle switch to it, and I absolutely love it. The control is really easy. Accompanied with the Enduroflex flapper discs, super sharp. Waste no time at all cleaning these edges up and getting everything cleaned up. There's a good shot right there of my angle grinder holder. The thing works really cool. There it is, nice cleaning the edges up. And now we're moving on. Now this right here is going to be the round part of the tool itself that's going to be welded on. Now I'm using what's called DMO. Drawn over mandrel is what they tell me that stands for. And what that is, this is an 1¼-inch pipe with 3/4 ID that has no seam on the inside. In other words, there's no seam. There's nothing to catch it, the piece of 3/4 that goes through there. It's nice and clean fit. A little bit pricey, but really nice product. Just over here at the Burr King deburring and kind of taking the edges off prior to getting things welded into position. And today we're going to be working off the Everlast Power Tig 255 EXT. And I've had this for about a year now, and I've been working with it for quite some time and trying to get used to it. And you know, the interface is a little bit intimidating, but once you figure it out, it's really easy, and it's been a really nice machine to work with. I'm operating with some 50-50. This is 50% argon, 50% helium today. And there's my TIG lead torch holder. Works really good. The torch is a CK17 water cooled, or not 17, I believe it's like a 20. I'm not certain of the number, but it is a water cooled version of that. And I'm using 2% of the length. I need a tungsten 3/32, and then we're just using some ER7006 mild steel for filler rod today. So the very first thing I want to do is to get these pieces of pipe that are going to be are in the hole. I want to get them tacked in several locations, four locations all the way around. And you can see as soon as I hit the heat to it on that side, it draws it over. So I'm trying to get everything perfectly plumb, get everything pulled back. And that's exactly what happens here. As soon as everything gets perfectly plumb, I get the four tacks on it, and it's ready to weld. Yeah, I just repeated the same process on the other one, and so far so good. That's coming together pretty nice. You know, this being mild steel and the other one being aluminum, believe it or not, there is a weight difference between the two, but not as much as you'd think there is. You know, this one here is a little bit heavier. It might be a pound, a little bit more than a pound, maybe 2 pounds heavier than the other one. And all in all, it's really not too bad. This is what the person wanted. They did not want the aluminum anymore. They wanted this mild steel, and that's what we're doing. So I've cleaned this metal up pretty good. You know, the tubing itself is like a cold rolled on the outside, so it's already pretty much clean. The plate has a little bit of mill scale on it. And I went ahead and just cleaned off as best I could. And even that, it looks like you're seeing a little porosity there, but it's actually just some black material left over. It actually welded in there really nice and clean. And that's the front side. This is the back side. Even though this is going to be down on the dirt, I still wanted to get a clean weld on the bottom side here. I am going to grind that flat down, but I still wanted the adhesion on the bottom to make it as strong as possible right there. You know, when you get things up in the air like this, you can see that I've got it blocked up. Sometimes I got to use propping material to get myself propped up in a position to, you know, to make things a little bit easier. You might see that a little bit later on in the video. There's the torch itself. I'm using a number 8 Furic Pyrex cup right there with a 3/32 lanthanated tungsten. That seems to work out really good. Those Pyrex cups, I got that from Jody over at WeldingTipsAndTricks.com. You know, those make for me especially, you know, I'm able to see right through the Pyrex welding, and it's really, really a nice added feature to the TIG torch. You can see there it is. I'm propping up on a piece of pipe right there. You know, I'm 60 years old. I'm not as steady as I used to be, and any help that I can get is sure welcomed at this point, that's for sure. Yeah, you know, the 255 has been working flawlessly. I've had no issues with it at all. Once you got used to the settings, which is really simple, it has really been a dream. And you know, this water cooler is a great added feature. You know, I also have the 210XT, which you're going to see here momentarily. I also use that in this video. You know, that's an air cooled torch, but the water cooler, you can certainly notice a difference, especially when you're welding with some bigger amps and a longer period of time. That torch head does not get hot at all. It stays nice and cool. And yeah, there's just some more welding right here on the on the bottom side of the plate to get these tubes welded into place. You know, another thing you can't see is inside my hood, my helmet right there, I've also got a cheater lens, you know, to bring me in focused in really nice and tight. Again, my sight's not as what it used to be, but those cheater lenses are available, and they're really handy to have. Once again, we're just grinding that down nice and flat as I can. I'm not trying to get it absolutely perfect right here, but I am trying to get the raised part of the weld ground down, and that's really all we really need to do. You know, this is something that that I got a few years ago. This is the notch mask from JD Squared. You know, I bought this for a particular project, and I was a little reluctant at first because it was kind of pricey, and I wasn't certain whether or not I could justify spending the money. Well, I went ahead and jumped out there and did that anyway. I'm a firm believer in quality, and you know, I've used it several times in the last few years, and here is just a good example of how well it works, you know. This is a small diameter pipe right here, and just clamp it into position, and this thing just cuts through, and you can just cut right through the material you need, and it just leaves a perfect bevel on the other side. And you know, it takes literally seconds for this to happen. You know, for me, that's pretty good. You can see right here, I'm kind of just freehand marking this thing where it needs to go. Take it back over there, clamp it in, and cut it up. A little lubrication like this is all you need. And this is sped up a little, but not too much. But it definitely cuts pretty clean, pretty fast. Definitely no complaints with the Notch Master. Here's another close-up shot of, I just thought it was interesting to just see the smoke coming off of there and the cutting. It's a pretty cool little shot. I just wanted to throw that in there. And once I got that done, just took it over, and just here's the fit right here. Right in there, perfect, just like that. It's totally weldable all the way around. Got all four pieces done. That worked out really well. And you can see that I have these handy little blocks of different sizes, you know, for all different things. And here's a good example of, again, how to use these blocks. I've just managed to hang on to these for various things over the years, and just use them for all different types of things. Now I'm switched over to the Power TIG 210 EXT right here. And this is a number 9 air-cooled torch with a little button on the end. And I'm using that to get in tight around underneath the bottom to get these welds up underneath the bottom of the handle right there. You know, it's kind of tricky to get in there, but with this torch on a little button like that, made it pretty easy. Everything's going along here pretty good. I'm pretty pleased with the way things are turning out. Again, just, you know, moving things around, propping things up the way you need to in order to get into position to get things done. Just need to figure it out as you go along, especially for me. You know, some of these guys can just sit there flat and go at it and go all the way around, but yeah. I'm not there, I should say. This is a 3/4 solid round bar stock, cold rolled, and then this is back again, some of that round stock left over, and we're going to be using this for the head of the pins. They're about 1 inch long, You know, the pin that was given to me with the plate that was damaged, the pin was bent, the head was mushroomed over. The whole thing, he told me, was trash. But this is kind of something like what they wanted. I was able to straighten that pin out that they had, ground down the mushroom dad, put one of these round heads on the end of the existing one, and that worked out really good. And so here we are making four more to go with the plates right here. Now, I'm not a machinist by any means. I've only been doing this for, a year or two. You know, my father-in-law had given me this old 42-inch Atlas, and with little or no learning experience, I'm self-taught. Now, some of the things that I'm doing here may not be the right order. I'm sure I'll be getting some comments from these machinists out there. You should have done this, you should have done that, and that's great, and I appreciate all the comments. It's not like I machine all the time, but this is what I did with this. I was able to take the top part of the lathe tooling cutter right there. I'm not certain what it's called, but I spun it around 180 degrees and put it on the angle that I needed for this point. And so basically I just used the feed and just ran that thing through and moved it and kept moving it. And the angle that I was looking for turned out perfectly. So it worked out good for me anyway. You know, this lathe is, I don't do much lathe work, but for what I've used it for, I haven't had a failure yet. I've been able to accomplish everything I need to accomplish with this little piece of equipment here. It's pretty cool. And just like that, there it is right there. And just a little file to take some of the burr off. And I'm leaving it like that. All four pieces done. Again, here we are with some blocks. There's a different block that I had. This one worked out pretty good. I've put the little end piece on, and I'm using that to with the mag square to hold things nice and square and in place while I go ahead and finish TIG welding this out all the way around. And I am going to be doing this on both the bottom and the top side as well. And this is what's going to create the head for the top of the pin. You know, one thing I didn't mention on this, is the filler rod that we're using on this. I switched around from 3/32, 16 to 1/8 inch, depending on a couple of things. And I found that, the 3/32 was the optimal, the most comfortable rod to be using, filler rod to be using for me in this situation. There's a good example, again, of me propping up, nice and steady work to get around the top of this, the pins like that. Just like that, just a little dome on there. And that's all I really needed to do. That's all I really wanted to do. And then I just took it over to the Burr King and just slightly rounded over the edge to create a round dome type look. And that's, I'm going to call that good, finished product right there. A little closer shot. You know, with this, with the Burr King and comfortable with the 3M belt, oh my gosh, it's crazy how well that thing works. There's all four pieces and all the pins. All we need to do now is just get a little bit of paint on them. And that's what I'm using right here. Now, this paint right here, I use this brand all the time. But this particular color, don't know what it is, but it dries almost immediately. You spray it on and it is dry almost immediately, where the same brand or different colors sometimes take a couple hours to dry. But this quick little project right here, this is the color that they wanted. I got a good cut, good coat of paint on both the front side and the back side. This was literally just a minute later, 2 minutes later. And that's cool. I really like the way you can just paint and it can be dried immediately. The project is done. Well, there it is. It's all complete. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Don't forget to check out my store, jimbosgarage.com. Maybe you saw some of the torch leads I had and torch lead holders I had there. Might be useful for you, as long as some swag that I may have. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to rate, comment, subscribe for more video.
See you next time on Jimbo's Garage.